Hi, good to see you here. And we are presenting you today something which is bothering almost everybody who has either started a restaurant or running a restaurant or planning to start one. And the question is, how do you look at costing? How do you calculate your food costing? So those softwares can do that for you, but we have come across a very simple technique. Very easy technique which can give you planned costing as well as the actual food costing when you are running the operation. The idea is to give you the basic concept so that you can do it on your own, you can do it on Excel, you can do it on software, and you understand what does it mean. So starting from a recipe, we are explaining you how do you look at your planned food cost, how do you look at your actual food cost month after month, so that you can have a meaningful comparison between the two. So let's get on, let's understand what this thing. This is, I have taken this video from one of our Q&A sessions, which we regularly hold for our boot camp participants. So boot camp is a course which we run for people who, want to get into food business or who are running into food business and want to understand basics about it. So this is from one of those Q&A sessions for you. Enjoy this video.
Yeah. So this is the recipe. I have just downloaded the recipe as it was. Quantity was given for 3 portions: coriander seeds, jeera, black pepper, Kashmiri red chili, oil, garlic, ginger, onion, tomato, butter, etc., etc., etc. All these things. Now, what is important is first we need to make assumption as per recipe. Finally, we are going to make this food as per recipe. So we are looking at, let us say, coriander seeds. Coriander seed, UOM is unit of measurement. This is very critical. How are we measuring it in terms of gram, in terms of ml, in terms of any other, when we are into the bakery industry, it is more in terms of teaspoon, tablespoon, cups, etc. So here, UOM or unit of measurement is important. So let's say coriander seeds, we estimate 35 grams. Now, I don't think 35 gram coriander seeds are required in Kadahi Paneer, but I have just taken a figure. Jeera is 25 gram, black pepper is 5 gram, dried Kashmiri red chili. So dried Kashmiri red chili is 10 grams, 2 teaspoon oil, 60 ml. I have just taken an assumption. Now, here comes the interesting part. 3 cloves of garlic. I can do a calculation. 3 cloves of garlic can be 3.5 gram or 4 gram. From in finance, we have a principle of approximation. So 3.5, 4 grams, I don't think at this stage in this business we need to get into such an intricate detail. So wherever I see the amount is pretty low or it is very insignificant, I have not bothered with the quantity and rate. I have just said approximately, and I have taken a value. 60 paise is the approximate value of garlic cloves which we are using. Ginger, similarly, 1 rupee 25 paise is what my assumption is. Now, same when we come to onion, tomato, butter, of course, we have this. Then we have butter, tejpatta, methi. Wherever I see the value is insignificant, I have taken approximation. Whenever the quantity is available, I have taken quantity. Like this, I have first measured the quantity. Then I have put in the rate. Now, here I have to be careful. UOM, whatever I have selected, if the UOM is gram, the rate has to be per gram. If the UOM is ml, the rate has to be per ml. Cooking oil, it is 145 rupees per liter. But because my unit of measurement is ml, I have to put it rate here, 145 divided by 1000. Now, this is where we need to be careful. Once we do that, then it is a simple multiplication of quantity and rate. Quantity and rate, you come towards it, you look at the total material cost. We have mentioned on the top that we are making this for 3 portions. So three portions, if the total cost is 154 rupees, per portion cost is 51 rupees. MRP of this kadahi paneer is 260 rupees. So we come to a food cost of 20%, planned food cost. Now this is how we calculate our planned food cost. When we come to the actuals, when we look at our monthly figures, the figures will look something like this. For all these inventory items, whatever was mentioned in the recipe, we will have some opening stock, we will have some purchase during the month, we'll have some closing stock. If you add opening stock plus purchase minus closing stock, you get monthly consumption. All are in rupee value. When you are maintaining your material ledger, you will maintain both quantity and rupee. Here, what we are talking about is, here we are talking about rupee value. And after this comes this most crucial part, which is percentage allocation. Now, why this percentage allocation is important? Because coriander seed, dhania, you are not using only for kadahi paneer. It is used for 10 other dishes also. You have total 34 items in the menu, and out of 34, total 12 items are using coriander seeds. You are having paneer in kadahi paneer, but at the same time, paneer is used in 6 dishes. Now, when you have multiple use of the same raw material, how do you divide the cost? You divide the cost in terms of proportion of how many plates you sold. For example, paneer is used in kadahi paneer, shahi paneer, paneer butter masala, 3 dishes. Kadahi paneer you sold 5 portions, shahi paneer 2 portions, paneer butter masala 10 portions. So total sale is 10 plus 5 plus 2, which is 17. Allocation for kadahi paneer will be 5 divided by 17 of the total cost. 5 divided by 17, you are not going to do this every day. You will do it only end of the month. And how do you do it at end of the month in a convenient manner? You have your POS system. The billing machine gives you item-wide sale figure. That is the basis how you arrive at this allocation, because you know item-wide sale figure. So now this percentage allocation, you multiply your total consumption with this percentage allocation and you come to the allocated value. Like that, you do this, you come to total food cost for kadahi paneer during the month, which is 647 rupees. Total sales for kadahi paneer during the month, 2880 rupees, and your actual food cost is 22%. Typically, what happens when you are using a software? Software does this calculation, recipe management and allocation and consumption, on an automated basis. You have to program it once. But if you know this logic, you can do it yourself. You can set the formula in Excel, and every month you just copy paste. You don't need to rewrite the formula every time. So I'm telling you the basics so that you can even do it on pen and paper. After this, whatever upgrade you are having, whether you are having it on Excel, whether you are having it on Tally, whether you are having it on, you know, Marg or some other software, that's a complete different issue. But this is the fundamental of food costing. I hope I'm clear. You know?